Thanks very much, Graham. What I actually want to do today is talk less about Wiley specifically and more give a general publisher perspective on intermediary solutions that are being developed for supporting text and data mining. I mean, John and Ed and Sarah no doubt will provide more detail of their projects later, but I just want to give a brief overview of why we feel that intermediary services are useful. So to start by recapping a little, as we know, the scale and complexity of contemporary STM publishing makes extracting knowledge from information very difficult. If we go to Jonathan's example of the Watson and Crick paper from 1953, it's fantastically written, isn't it? We wish to suggest a structure for the salt of deoxyribonucleic acid. The structure has novel features of considerable biological interest. It's wonderful. If only our authors could write like that today. It's two pages, two authors, one figure, no supplemental information, six references. Compare that with an article from our journal, Proteomics, which you can't see very well. 11 pages, six authors, four figures, external supplemental information, 66 references, and so on and so on. So scientific information is increasingly complex. It's growing exponentially in complexity. And I think T.S. Eliot summed this up quite well many years ago. Where's the knowledge we have lost in information? And obviously, text and data mining of published information is seen as a potential solution here. Why is it important? For publishers, it can enrich published content, add value for customers, enable development of new products. For researchers, identification of new hypotheses, new patterns, facts, knowledge. Corporate R&D, acceleration of drug discovery and development, maximizing the value of information spend. And commercial users can develop new products based on cross-publisher mining and entity extraction, whether that's patent information, whether that's drug discovery, product information for marketing purposes, Efka mentioned market sentiment analysis of Twitter, all these kind of things. I think it is worth saying, though, that the benefits of text mining are still highly speculative. There's real lack of concrete use cases and examples, no standard process or outputs. But from the Wiley perspective, we want to encourage innovative uses of content. We want to develop capabilities to enhance our content through text and data mining, because as William Gibson said, ahead of us, there is merely more stuff. There is going to be more stuff, more publications, more articles, more complexity that we need to negotiate. So what are the barriers to text and data mining that could potentially be solved by intermediary solutions? Access. Alistair talked in detail about this. I thought that was an excellent summary. How do users get hold of content for mining? Do they crawl the platform? Is it an FTP delivery? Is it through an API? There are no standard content formats. There's no standard cross-publisher format. Evaluation from the publisher side. What about understanding user use cases and needs? There's uncertainty, as Richard summarized very well. What is allowed by law? What use can be made of TDM output? Where's the law taking us? What is the legislative framework doing? In terms of business models, there are no established business models, no established pricing models. What about access to unsubscribed content? The value of text mining, of course, is in the aggregate. Not everyone subscribes to everything every publisher publishes. And also the question of scale, about how to define and manage demand. Bilateral licensing really is unlikely to be scalable. So I want to talk a bit more about that. Now, I think it's also really worth saying that from a publisher perspective, we don't see text mining in and of itself as an issue. The key questions, again, as Alistair summarized, are about access to content and then about how that content is used. We don't want unauthorized reuse and redistribution. We don't want the creation of substitutive products. We don't want the creation of commercial services based on published content. Whether a copyright exception will answer any of those questions, I'm not sure. Let's go talk about intermediary services for a bit. This is your standard bilateral one-to-one licensing relationship, licensing negotiation, content delivery. This is Wiley speaking to University of California, Santa Cruz, or any other commercial partner. It's a very simple relationship. There's a potential for developing a mutually beneficial relationship in terms of content normalization or providing enriched content or allowing access to unsubscribed material. But in reality, this kind of approach just doesn't scale. It's not a one-to-one conversation. It's going to be a one-to-many conversation. That's me in the middle trying to talk to 20, 30 people about how to enable text mining. And in effect, it's actually a many-to-many because each of those end users is going to be talking to every publisher as well. So there's a whole raft of conversations going on that can't be handled simply and easily by bilateral licensing. So an intermediary service sitting between the publisher and the end user potentially can offer a real way of providing an effective solution to some of the problems we're experiencing with text and data mining. It could offer a defined set of services and act as a broker between the publisher and the end user. And some of the industry initiatives in this area, not all of them are still active, not all of them reach the market. The STM and the Pharma Documentation Ring negotiated a model license for text mining. The PLS was discussing a clearinghouse for requests. The PA was looking at a click-through license. Copyright Clearance Center has a pilot TDM platform, which John is going to talk about later. Similarly, Ed will talk about Crossref's prospect solution. So there's a lot of activity here. And the benefits, I think, are that an intermediary service would provide a single point of access and delivery, would provide a standard licensing terms for end users. It would give speed and ease of access, and be extensible and scalable, which often, as I said, bilateral publisher licensing isn't. And I think really crucially, there's a potential to cover the long tail of publishers and end users. It's not all about the big three, the big five, the big 10 publishers who have people who can take care of this, who have quite sophisticated content delivery methods. There's a huge long tail of publishers who just aren't involved in this conversation right now. And I think intermediary solutions really will help that engagement. I think one important piece to mention as well is that an intermediary service will help pharmaceutical access, because one of the issues there is often about confidential access, knowing what material is being accessed and by whom. So the aim here would be to support text and data mining really in the most efficient and effective manner, irrespective of the model used, whether that's the central platform as advocated by CCC or more of a distributed content negotiation version I believe Crossref are working on. And so the potential outcomes here would be to gain a much better understanding of user and market needs, to be able to develop services that manage content access and delivery in a scalable manner, to eliminate the need for bilateral licensing and individual negotiation. There'll also be the potential to develop new business models, particularly around unsubscribed content. Remember what I said about the value of text mining being in the aggregate, not in the small number of articles. And I think also intermediary solutions allow for extension into the academic, research, and library space, which would solve a significant further access issue. And on that very hopeful note, I'll finish. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Duncan. I think that's going to tie in quite neatly with what we're going to hear towards the end of this seminar, and seems sensible to me. Any quick questions for Duncan, based on that straight through?